Yeah, I remember the day I got drafted. It was the first time I had the privilege to meet him, and yeah, I don't know, it's pretty speechless at the moment. I'm not sure really what to say. He's had such an impact on so many people, and yeah, me personally, just yeah, being able to speak to him and sort of learn off of him and just realise how much of an impact he's had in the, I suppose, the whole world. So no, he's, I say it all the time and I'll say it again, he's definitely the most inspirational person I've ever met and probably ever will meet.
It's probably unfortunately been a really long battle for him, but still it seems as if
he was
in a bit of shock.
Yeah, like, I don't know, it's, you just assume now how much of a fighter he is that he would be around, so you didn't think this day would ever actually come, and now that it has, obviously it's very sad, and yeah, just like to acknowledge his family and close friends and all the past captains and players that have played with him and been involved with him. Yeah, it's going to be a very sad couple of days and weeks, but yeah, there's not much more I can say. At the moment, I think they're in talks that we're going to have round four against the Western Bulldogs as a sort of tribute match towards Jimmy. They decided that they didn't really want to make it round one, his family, because you know, people will still be mourning the loss, and it's pretty soon, it's only a week and a half away, so I think we're going to yeah, sort of lead into round four and make it a whole league-wide sort of tribute to Jimmy Steins and what he's done.
Did the playing group get together early this morning, or how have you guys spent today?
Yeah, we met this morning and obviously heard the news just before we went out to train, and Cam Schwab came in and spoke to us and obviously told us the news, and it was just the whole group and the whole room was silent and just shocked, because like Jack said, you just with Jimmy, you never thought this day would come. He's such a fighter and his battle has been going for so long, you just assume that he's going to pull through. And yeah, our thoughts just go out to Sam and the kids and his family and all the friends and all the millions of people that he's touched along the way as well. It's impacted a lot of people.
Jack, it must have been hard to
Well, I think the one thing that Jimmy would have wanted is not to dedicate, whether it's round one or round four, and get up for one game and have a really good performance in his honour. I think Jimmy's been all about all along is changing this club's culture and getting it back to where it should be. And we'll definitely be striving to do that and do everything within our power to get there, because yeah, to honour a man like that would be a great thing.
What would you say that you've
Can you move back on the right, please?
You move back.
He's obviously pretty much dedicated his life to others, and the amount of people that he's touched along the way, he's a very selfless person, and as you see, this battle that he's been going through, and he's still putting himself out there to others to try to help others and not himself, when he was the one that needed it the most. And we just heard, we had Don McClarty just speak to us before, and to see the real emotion that was going through him when he was speaking to us about Jimmy was, you realise the sort of impact that he has on people, being a really close mate and Don, and yeah, I don't think we can sort of comprehend the actual person he was and how hard this loss is going to be to take for so many people.
Compared to the piece before you got drafted, like, how much does sort of Jimmy have a sort of a big figure in, you know, the way you got through your life at the club?
Well, definitely. Jimmy was my dad's favourite player growing up, and I heard a lot about Jimmy, and I remember the sadness that went through my family the day he retired. And now, like, the impact he obviously had in his playing days and the impact he's had since he's been at the club, we wouldn't be standing here today in these colours if it wasn't for Jimmy Steins. And we really see him as a hero. He saved the Melbourne Footy Club, and we owe him everything we have, because, like I said, we wouldn't be here without him. So now that he's obviously gone, I think it's time we need to honour the loss, but not in, like I said, one game or in round four. It's getting this club back to where it needs to be.
Jack touched on it, but just do you really think that, that you wouldn't be here? I mean, a lot was made of the debt demolition, obviously, that he instigated and wiped out. I think the club was in debt for 3 decades. He's part in that, and do you think you'd be here without him?
Oh, no, no doubt. The club would be nothing like it is at the moment if it wasn't for Jimmy Steins. Jack mentioned earlier that Cam Schwab hopped up and sort of went through his career and all the achievements that he sort of achieved throughout his journey. And you know, there was a time there a few years ago where the club really needed someone to stand up, and you know, Jimmy took it on board as he has his whole career and stood up when he was needed. And you know, he's the reason for the club to get out of the debt that we were in and get the new coaches and new players within this club. So, you know, now we've just got to honour that and keep his legacy going and really build to get some success that he deserves.